In this lecture, we shall study reflection at curved surfaces. In fact, basic principle remains the same as the one we saw in reflection from plane surfaces. Laws of reflection will hold in both these cases. So first, what is curved surface reflection? You saw plane mirror. Plane mirror has silvering on one side. Light comes and is reflected back. However, as the name signifies, curved mirror is curved. Now, if you have silvering on this side, then light will come from this side and be reflected onto this side. Such mirrors are called concave mirror. And if you have light, if you have surface which is polished like this, then the light will come from this side and go off like this, and such surfaces are called convex mirror. One common example of spherical mirror is the rear view mirror of the what you see in car. Side view mirror that you have is basically a spherical mirror. Now, there are certain terms that we use in when we refer to reflection at curved surface, and this is what we'll introduce now. Suppose this is a concave mirror, silvering is on the right side. Then the geometric center of this mirror is called the pole. Center of curvature, the other term that we use is the center of the circle which actually contains this mirror. I'm just drawing for the simplicity. So, though it doesn't look like a circle, but to illustrate the point, this therefore will be the center of curvature. We will call this C, and the imaginary line that we assume to be going from pole to center of curvature is called principal axis. Now, the radius of curvature is nothing but the distance from the pole to center of curvature, or nothing but the radius of the sphere that we had taken earlier. So these terms will be used for convex mirror in the same fashion. Now we discuss two terms. One, the principal focus of concave mirror. To understand this, let's go to the basics. You have studied that pole is geometric center and radius of curvature is the center of the circle, which is for which we have this part here. Any line that you have studied in geometry drawn from center of circle to any part of the circle will then be normal. So this means any line drawn from center of curvature to any part of the mirror will be normal to the mirror. This has an important implication. So wherever you take, in fact, even if you take it here or here or here, everywhere it will be normal. You know that principal axis is yet another normal line passing through pole and center of curvature. Now what is the principal focus? If the rays of light are coming from infinity, this is incident ray, and this you have seen is normal, this incident ray will get reflected, and angle made by reflected will be the same as angle made by incident with the normal here. So you make the angle same and then draw. So rays will pass like this. And similarly, you will have another side, incident ray, and the reflected ray will pass like this for this other side. And they appear to be meeting at a point on the principal axis. So, I summarize, we have drawn the normal, any line from center of curvature to the mirror is normal. Incident ray angle and the reflected angle has to be same as per law of reflection. And the point where these reflected rays meet on principal axis is called principal focus of concave mirror. Now, interestingly, that what you see is that there is rays are actually meeting in this case. So such rays can be taken on screen, and therefore such situation is called formation of real image. Whereas in the plane mirror reflection that we studied, let us go back to that. Recall reflection in the plane mirror, rays were appearing to be coming from this side. In fact, there was no ray here technically. It was because of this reflection happening like this, we felt as if they are coming from here. Naturally, we cannot take this image on the screen. Therefore, this is virtual image. Whereas this here is the real image of infinite object at infinity formed at the point that we call focus. Whereas if you compare the case with a convex mirror, however, in the case of convex mirror, you know that the silver ring is on here. Now, if this be the part of, let's say, a sphere or a circle, then notice that this circle that we will try to cover it up will have a center on the side of silver ring. So center of curvature of convex mirror actually lies on the other side, unlike in the case of concave mirror where it was on the same side where the rays were there. Now, if we see this and rays will be coming from this side, infinite rays coming from infinity, geometric center of this mirror will be the pole, and the line joining, imaginary line joining this and extending like this, will be the principal axis. Now you have seen that line drawn from center of curvature to any part on this mirror, because it's a part of a circle, will be the normal. Therefore, the angle that incident ray makes in this case with the normal is this, and you will suffer reflection on this side with same angle. So, and similarly, if you can take another ray, it also gets reflected in a similar manner. And when you will proceed these rays, they will appear to be meeting at a point on the principal axis that we call the focus point for the convex mirror. Naturally, they are appearing. Light energy cannot come this side where the silver ring is there. It is an illusion that we feel the rays are coming from this. So this is principal focus of convex mirror. Now this leads us to the rules for drawing geometric images for spherical mirrors. Rule number one that you have already seen, that rays which are parallel to principal axis Let this ray or this ray here are reflected, either actually they pass through a point called focus, that is after reflection they actually pass through a point which we call focus, which is the case of concave mirror here, or they appear to be coming from a point on the principal axis called the focus in the case of convex mirrors. So a parallel ray, incident ray parallel to principal axis will give you location of focus both in the case of concave mirror as well as convex mirror. The second rule is actually opposite of the point one. If a ray is coming from focus, that is opposite of the case that we have studied, then after reflection, as per law of reflection, it will become parallel to principal axis. See, this is as per the law of reflection. If you will take this ray, this will be your incident angle, and after reflection the angle will be the same. So similarly here, if a ray appears to be incident on a particular point on principal axis, then after reflection it will become parallel like this in the case of convex mirrors. So you will say any ray which passes through principal focus, which is the case here, which is the case in concave mirror, or appears to travel along principal focus, which is the case here, it is appearing actually, it's a dotted line here, so which is the case of convex mirror. After reflection will travel parallel to principal axis. And this also gives you the third rule. If a ray is passing through center of curvature and strikes on the mirror, or appears to be traveling along center of curvature, after reflection travel back along the initial path. See, reason is very simple. See, this is center of curvature, and if you take a ray going like this, then the angle that it makes with the normal is zero, therefore the reflected angle will also be zero, so it will come back on the same path. Similarly here, if a ray appears to be traveling towards center of curvature, which is this line here, then it will, after reflection it will come back like this. Angle of incidence was zero, therefore reflected angle will also be zero. So we write this: any ray of light which passes through center of curvature, which is the case here, it is actually passing through center of curvature, concave mirror case, or appear to travel along the center of curvature, which is the case here, it is appearing as if it is traveling along center of curvature, after reflection travel back along the initial path. So these three rules will be used off and on in many situations. So we have seen the case where object is at infinity, rays are coming parallel, and then they will meet in case of concave mirror at focus, and in case of convex mirror will appear to be meeting at the focus.